An American journalist working in Venezuela who contributes to Catholic News Service has reportedly been taken into custody after an early morning raid on his home. This comes as the U.S. is stepping up punitive measures against the Maduro regime. Vice President Mike Pence announced the latest crackdown at the Latino Coalition Legislative Summit. White House correspondent Mark Irons was there, and now he joins us from the North Lawn. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Lauren. Vice President Pence says there can be no bystanders in the struggle for freedom. He calls on other countries to recognize Juan Guaido as Venezuela's president and reject the old Maduro regime.
Today, the State Department is announcing that the United States will revoke 77 visas, including many officials of the Maduro regime and their families. We will continue to hold the Maduro regime accountable until libertad is restored in Venezuela.
Before the vice president spoke today, Republican Senator Ted Cruz fired a warning shot to Venezuelan military officials.
For any individual army general in Venezuela to understand, if you choose the tyrant over the people, the consequences for you will be dire. But if you choose the people of Venezuela, the benefits of liberty are extraordinary.
Living in Venezuela comes with risk, especially for a free press. A journalist who contributes to Catholic News Service has reportedly been captured in Venezuela.
Buenos dias.
Cody Weddle just yesterday filed a report for the ABC affiliate in Miami. Then, this morning, a reporters' union tweeted that military investigators raided his home in Venezuela and took him into custody, along with his colleague. The Trump administration supports the people in Venezuela, but the president threatened to cut aid to Central American countries like Honduras, El Salvador, and Guatemala, since they didn't stop migrant caravans headed to the U.S.
I know people from Honduras and Guatemala, and their stories are quite sad.
Ophelia Acosta, originally from Mexico, attended today's Latino Coalition event. She believes the president's words and actions aren't helpful to migrants. She says it breaks her heart to hear about family separations at the southern border.
Because I came when I was three, and my mom and three of us were brought to the U.S., and I can't even imagine being left apart from them.
The State Department is now demanding the release of that U.S. journalist who was arrested in Venezuela. One official says President Maduro prefers to stifle truth rather than face it, and being a journalist is not a crime. Lauren.
White House correspondent Mark Irons. Thank you, Mark.